This video is sponsored by MuscleMonsters.com. Muscle Monsters is the fastest growing supplement brand for men who want to maximize their effort in the gym, optimize total body health, and make gains in every arena of life. Whatever your performance goals are, if you want to reach the next level and get the results you desire and deserve, don't wait. Click the link in the description and head over to MuscleMonsters.com. Use promo code MONSTER to get 25% off plus free shipping.
Look back through the thousands and thousands of years before the 21st century. Men didn't become attractive by working in an office setting with their laptop and cell phone. Instead, they had to hunt, fight, and kill for food. So women would see fit men who were able to get food and reproduce as being more attractive. Yes, society has changed a bit, but by the looks of it, this genetic programming still exists. This is even confirmed in research. According to one study published in Evolutionary Psychology, women have a greater attraction to men who are muscular. Another study supports that women simply prefer men who not only have some muscle, but also are stronger and leaner. For this study, they took college students from the gyms as well as psychology classes and tested their weightlifting strength. The researchers blocked out their faces so women could focus on their physiques. The women then rated the men on a scale of 1 to 7 for how strong they appear. It turns out, women are really good at perceiving how strong a man is based on his physique. Women also rated them on their attractiveness. Based on the feedback, the strongest men were seen as the most attractive. Now, I should add that this doesn't mean muscles are everything. I'd even say that most women are disgusted by overly muscular bodies. Research by Frederick and Haselton suggests the same. Women like a man with some muscle, but not too much. Just think of the pro bodybuilders who graced the Olympia stage. While their physiques are impressive, most women will not find their bodies physically attractive as they're too extreme. At this point, it's clear that women are attracted to men who are moderately muscular, strong, and lean. In this video, however, we're going to take it one step further. I'm going to share the top 5 muscles women find most attractive. This list will be based on the combination of research, what women seem to respond to, and personal experience. So, without further ado, let's jump right in. Number 5. Shoulders. Women are attracted to men with broad shoulders. Besides the aesthetic component, it also makes men specifically appear more formidable. Formidability is a character trait that makes sense based on evolution. Another study by Sell and colleagues suggests that appearing more formidable hints that you're better able to acquire resources for your family as well as defend them from threats. The shoulders are made up of 3 parts: the anterior delt, the middle delt, and the posterior delt. The fastest way to build broad masculine shoulders is to develop each of these heads. That said, between all of the pushing and pulling you're already doing, it's unlikely your front and rear delts are underdeveloped. I'd argue, however, the lateral head of the shoulders is both the most neglected and the most important for an attractive aesthetic physique. While you're already hitting the mid-delts anytime you're pressing a weight overhead, they're not stimulated enough to produce significant growth from that alone. Your best bet is to include lateral raises or some form of lateral raise variation with a strong mind-muscle connection 2 to 3 times per week. Here's an example of a schedule you can follow. Monday, 1-arm leaning cable lateral raises for 4 sets of 10 to 12 reps. Wednesday, dumbbell lateral raises for 3 sets of 10 to 12 reps. And Friday, 1-arm leaning cable lateral raises for 3 sets of 12 to 15 reps. Remember, especially with isolation movements like the lateral raise, you need to prioritize proper technique so you activate the proper muscle and actually bring it close to failure. Number 4. Glutes. The reason women are attracted to a nice butt probably has to do with the athleticism and strength involved. The glutes are one of the most powerful muscles in the body. Think back to our ancestors. When they had to sprint, jump, and fight, their glutes were producing the force needed to survive. So, if you have a flat butt, building it up could be the quickest way to become a bit more attractive. For most men, it may not even take much work. In fact, your current workout program may already include exercises that target the glutes to a great degree. While we do have EMG research that suggests the hip thrust is superior to the squat when it comes to glute activation, you have to consider that higher activation does not always mean more muscle growth. A 2020 study has finally compared the actual muscle growth that occurs between the squat and hip thrust. Not only did the squat result in 6 times greater growth in the quads, but they also led to 2 times more glute growth than the hip thrust. When you consider all the research out there and apply it to actually lifting in the gym, I can confidently say that you'll get the best glute growth by focusing on heavy compound movements like the squat, deadlift, Romanian deadlift, and lunges. This isn't to say we shouldn't include the hip thrust in our training. To the contrary, the hip thrust is a great way to add volume for your glutes without taxing other lower body muscles. Instead, what I am saying is that heavy compound lifts like squats and deadlifts should be the focal point of your glute training. Number 3. Chest. The chest is in fact one of the most attractive muscles to women. This is likely for 2 reasons. 1. Well-developed pecs make you look bigger and more formidable even when wearing a shirt. Like I mentioned before, women are attracted to masculine appearing men who can protect, fight, and hunt for food. 2. The pecs are one of the primary pushing muscles. Building up big pecs likely subconsciously suggests the ability to push when a threat is near. Now for the age-old question, how do you actually build your pecs? A 2014 paper from the Journal of Strength and Conditioning studied the relationship between how much you bench press and your pec size. Unsurprisingly, the guys who bench press more simply have bigger pecs. It's safe to say you can build bigger pecs by simply focusing on heavy bench pressing, be it with barbells or dumbbells. I also recommend you include some form of isolation movement that allows you to train the chest directly without having to worry about weaker secondary muscles. For example, let's say you hit your chest 2 times per week. One workout would include the following: the bench press for 4 sets of 5, an incline dumbbell press for 3 sets of 8, and a cable fly for 3 sets of 12. And because progressive overload is the main pathway by which we build muscle, focus on getting stronger, especially with the heavy compound movements. Number 2. Biceps. Curls for the girls couldn't have been a truer phrase. In one survey asking women which muscle they find the most attractive, the arms were at the top of the list, far above abs, chest, and even the coveted V-cut. Besides suggesting high upper body strength, I'd say the biceps are attractive because they tend to be visible, and bigger biceps are often associated with vitality and power. Lucky for us, the biceps aren't too complicated. After all, they're mainly responsible for elbow flexion or bending at the elbow, making them extremely easy to train. That said, if you're having trouble building your biceps, here's what I suggest. First, focus on heavier barbell and dumbbell bicep curls for overall growth. Then sprinkle in movements that train the biceps with the arm both in front as well as behind the body to ensure you're emphasizing all parts of the biceps. Also, because the biceps are biomechanically resistant to significant muscle damage, you can train them more frequently without hindering results. If you spread your biceps training across multiple days rather than just one, you'll not only increase total volume, but you'll elevate muscle protein synthesis more frequently, resulting in greater muscle growth. Number 1. Core. When I say the core is number 1, I'm pretty much referring to having a visible six-pack. Seeing a six-pack on a man essentially indicates that that man is fit and takes care of his body. Back to the previous study, women like lean, fit-looking men. Even if a woman will deny it, most of them are attracted to men with low body fat percentages, especially around the belly. A 2013 study published in the Archives of Medical Science suggests that inflammation is greater when a man has visceral fat. This is the fat surrounding your vital organs, and the inflammation it causes is linked to a host of diseases like cancer, heart disease, and diabetes. Obviously, a woman wants a man with the best health possible. If this doesn't sound bad enough, research also suggests abdominal fat is associated with low testosterone. That means if you're carrying some belly fat, your number one masculine hormone is likely compromised. So, if women want a disease-free, testosterone-filled man, she likely will be attracted to a guy with a defined, toned core. Don't get me wrong, I'm not suggesting that you aim to get stage lean at 5% body fat, as that will likely cause your testosterone levels to plummet, but rather achieving a healthy body fat of somewhere between 8 to 12% will put you in a good position in terms of health and attractiveness. In terms of achieving a visible six-pack, the most important factor is your nutrition. It doesn't matter how many crunches you do, the abs will not be revealed unless you have a low enough body fat. That said, I still recommend including some direct ab work to really build your core muscles and make them pop. Otherwise, you could just end up with a flat stomach with no abs in sight. So, there you have it, the 5 most attractive muscles women can't resist. This isn't to say that women won't find you attractive if you don't look like a fitness model, but if you want a bit of an edge on the competition, focus on bringing these muscles up. Did you find this video helpful? If so, click the like button below as it'll truly help out the channel. And if you haven't already, make sure you subscribe for more videos and don't forget to click the notification bell so you don't miss the next one. Peace.